So most of us know by now that sunscreen is important to use.
But maybe we don't realize what you can do to make mistakes and even just the best way to apply it. Here to offer some tips on how to avoid those mistakes is GBMC's Dr. Rachel Plotnick. Good morning.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Of course. So when we talk about putting on the sunscreen, it's usually the parents that are doing it, but the parents are the ones that are making those common mistakes.
Absolutely.
What are they?
Not putting on enough is the main one.
Really?
You put a little bit in your hand. You're supposed to use like a shot glass full, 2 tablespoons worth every time. So that means you should be going through a container of sunscreen in like 8 applications.
Wow.
Oh my goodness. And so how often should you reapply it?
Every 2 hours.
Okay.
In general. And putting it on before you get in the water and a good 30 minutes prior. So ideally putting it on when you get your kid dressed for the pool, mm-hmm. not when you're right at the pool.
Okay. So let's talk about those days when we're in and out of the pool.
Yes.
Do we do it every time or?
Most of the sunscreens that you can buy are water resistant. So
right.
they'll handle getting in and getting out for about an hour and a half. Toweling dry and really, rubbing on sand and everything, you probably want to reapply more often, mm-hmm. but generally every hour and a half to 2 hours is enough.
Okay, so how much is too much? Because over the weekend, my girlfriends and I, we had the boys, they're all 2 at the pool, and I felt like every few minutes we were spraying and then they just were covered. Is it ever too much?
No, not really.
Oh, wow.
The sprays are hard though.
Okay.
I see their purpose when they're in and out and you might have sand on them. It's easier to do the sprays,
mm-hmm.
but it's a lot easier to make mistakes with the sprays because you can't see where it's on
mm-hmm.
and where it's not.
Okay.
So people tend to like spray it in the air. Well, that protects the air just fine, but
right.
doesn't protect your baby's really sensitive skin.
Right. And let's talk about those sprays, because I often find myself just spraying it on and then I don't rub it in after that because I can't really see it. I don't know where it is. Is that a mistake?
Yes.
Do you need to rub it in?
Absolutely.
So with the sprays, if they are waterproof or water resistant, it says, are they really?
Well, for about an hour and a half, two hours.
Okay.
Yeah. And you have to put them on before you get in the water. You can't just spray
right.
and dunk right in. It's just going to wipe right off.
Now, what are the best sunscreens for kids?
Generally, you want a broad spectrum sunscreen, which luckily most sunscreens are these days.
Okay.
You also want something with an SPF of 30 or higher in general. Anything more than that, people want to put on 100, but the problem with 100 is people think, oh, I can go out all day if it's 100.
Right.
Well, mm-hmm. it's going to wear off before you ever get to that 100 mark.
Right.
So,
what about expiration dates? I don't really ever look for one on a sunscreen bottle, but
yeah.
I guess they're
supposed to last about 3 years, and
okay.
they should have expiration dates on it. And if they don't, you can call the company and, point out the number, and they'll tell you the expiration date. However, you really should be using up your sunscreens
yeah,
before
right.
the expiration date. You should be going through several bottles every time you're on vacation, especially at the pool or beach where there's a lot of sun exposure.
Now, some of them say kids. Are there any chemicals that we should avoid for little ones? And if so, like what age?
Well, that's a great question. In general, the physical blocker sunscreens, those are the ones with titanium dioxide and zinc mm-hmm. in them, are less sensitive. They're great for kids who have sensitive skin because
okay.
they don't have that chemical component that in some sunscreens can make your skin really sensitized, itchy, burny, and stuff like that. So if you have a kid who ate sunscreen, go with the zinc oxide and titanium dioxide products.
What about for the face? Because now I see those sticks that
I think the sticks are excellent for
Good.
The face.
Okay.
I make my child use the stick on the face.
Uh-huh.
The thing about the physical blockers is they make their skin white, which some of the kids don't like.
Mm-hmm.
But however, that way you know where it went on. And
That's
you know
true.
When it's coming off, too.
That is true.
So it's really helpful for that. So I'm a big proponent of the sticks.
Is sunscreen enough, or should we do hats or anything else?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you can't replace the value of a physical blocking, shirts. Those rash guards are great.
Mm-hmm.
Hats, great. And especially in babies when you really don't know how sunscreen works and how well
right.
it works. So those under 6-month-old kids, you really want to always have in a wide brim hat.
What about the numbers, the 50 or the 100? Which one do we need?
At least 30 or higher, I
okay.
generally say. 15 probably okay. Anything more than 30 is just kind of a bonus and not really getting you much.
Wow.
Yeah.
So much
save your money.
Know. This is very helpful. Thank you so
You're
much.
You're very welcome.
Of course. All right. Well, speaking of the heat, if you want to get in on summer's hottest shopping deals, keep it